Imagine your mother, 60 years old, very active, walking, doing 6,000, 7,000, 8,000 steps a day, eating healthy, very active with all the friends. That is what we want. That's the new 40 of the new 60. But now imagine your mother is 80 years old, and now suddenly she's not so good anymore. She's kind of frail. She looks a little bit skinny, looks like she lost some muscle. She's not so active anymore. She has small problems, like she has a little bit diabetes, or she has maybe some arthritis. What we all want is to understand what happened in those 20 years. The research that I do a lot is trying to make this transition from 60 to 80 to even to 100 much better. And all the research that we do here indicates that, for instance, nutrition can play a very important role in addition to exercise. We found that the protein in your diet is such an important factor. But why is that? It's actually very simple. When people get older, they do less activity because of arthritis or other problems. There's less activity caused that the brain senses that there's not so much food needed, so all the people have a less desire to eat. By that, they just eat less of everything. And that for calories is not a problem, but for the protein in your diet, that's a major problem. So all the people will actually have a lack of enough protein in their diet. So the research that I do, and still do, and will do the coming many years, is how important will it be to provide more protein to older adults to make their life better. And we and others have really found that if you increase the protein intake even higher than healthy people like me take, that people stay in a better condition when they are older. In addition, we do a lot of research to see what happens if people are really sick, like somebody can get cancer, or have a COPD or a heart problem. In that situation, we actually found that more protein even is needed, higher amounts. What is protein? You would think about. Protein is meat, of course, but it's also dairy proteins, milk. In my research, we think that the dairy proteins are actually the easiest and the best proteins to put in your diet. Think about it. One glass of milk is 8 grams of protein, and a person needs about 50 to 75 grams of that. One cup of Greek yogurt is 22 grams of protein. So it is possible by regular taking these type of nutrients to increase the protein intake. You still would think, okay, is it that simple, just increasing your protein intake and I will stay healthy and live longer and do more exercise? I'm not sure, but there is something very interesting that we did last year. We published a paper in which we studied patients that were in the hospital, 650 patients that were malnourished or did not get enough protein. It was a multi-US, multi-city study. And we found that if you give these patients more protein in the diet and you follow them not only in the hospital, but all the way out after discharge to 90 days, that when you provide protein, more protein to these patients, that not 30 of these patients die, but only 15. In other words, by providing protein, even when people are sick or recovery, the survival is much better. Actually, I think this is an example that it is really necessary to think about the amount of protein in the diet. So the advice is more protein. It's very simple, and even it is higher than you think, 1 to 1.5 grams of protein per day. More exercise is really important, and also it can really make a difference when you are sick. So coming back to the mother of my mother, for instance, for 80 years old, if she would have had better nutrition, if I could have done that, I could not do it, but if I would have done that, and whether exercise would be part of that, she probably would have stayed in a better condition, would have less chance to become sick, but also would survive more and better when she had something in the hospital and went home. Thank you.